Welcome, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us on this Saturday. I am Cakes, and I'm here joined with Chakilski as well as Vamp. And you're watching a home team weekend from Chicago, Illinois, brought to you by the WFTDA Remote Studio and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association broadcasting team. This is hosted by the Windy City Rollers, and what you're about to enjoy is a game from Windy City. This is the third game broadcasted today, and these are the home teams. So earlier today, you were able to enjoy a doubleheader showcase from the squads from February 28th, and now we're moving on to the live game with Double Crossers taking on the Hells Bells. So Windy City Rollers are a veteran team with a legacy at the birth of WFTDA. So these two teams are just four home. These two teams that we're about to see are just two of four home squads fighting for the notorious Ivy King Cup, which will be held later in March 25th. So, Chai, who do we have skating for the Double Crossers this evening?
All right, skating for the Double Crossers today, we've got 125 Aaron Go Brawl, 138 Rat Tail, 140 Shrimp Blocktail, 16 Criss Cross, 1975 Nasty Al, 20 Millie Applebite, 21 Tricky Pixie, 312 Killanoid, 314 Valraven, 404 Beautiful Cinnamon Roll, Too Good for This World, Too Pure, 4-5 Poppin, 5-1-2 Cheeks, 5-1-6 Natty Bone Crusher, 5-3-0 Rough and Ready, 7-7-3 Malort Tisha, 8-1-5 Peekaboos.
All right, and then Vamp, who do we have skating on the Hell's Bells roster tonight?
All right, so tonight for Hell's Bells, we have Ficus, number 18. And then we have number 24, Bruise Clues, 253, Hella Fitzgerald, 27, Chelsea Dragger, 35, Fuzzkill, 350, Rachel Rage, 40, Boomba, 411, Blockadile Dundee, 47, Ramen Noodles, 53, Wendy Gnarling, number 6, Tina Fatal, 642, Code Green, 718, Betty Rage, 81, D-Ride, and 87, Chiquita.
All right, so we have plenty to talk about this evening, so we're excited that you are here to watch this with us. The Hell's Bells will be skating in the red tops with fun, sometimes leopard, great.
Excellent.
Are you able to hear me? So sorry.
Yeah,
I got you. I'm good.
Okay, there you are.
Yay. Two games earlier today. Were either of you able to watch either of those games? And what are you thinking so far for Windy City putting on this hometown showcase?
Not going to lie, I had a couple things going on earlier today, so I didn't get to catch them. But definitely... you know, it sounds like we're going to have a great game. Hell's Bells and Double Crossers are meeting up for the first time, so they're going to start fresh. They're going to, you know, test each other's boundaries, figure each other out at this point. So it's going to be a good game to watch.
Absolutely. What about you, Chai?
Same thing. Haven't been able to catch much derby today, but definitely excited to see what Windy City has going on this year for sure.
I mean, it's not the Fury, but who am I to say, right? That's neither here nor there. You know, we have people in the chat. If you want to give shout outs to your favorite skaters or coaches, I know we have a lot of locals in, you know, nearby that might want to jump on in. Let us know who your favorite officials are. Kit Ruff is in the chat right now, you know, here for the officials. I'm so excited that you're here to watch this with us. And they should be able to duke this out. And again, I talked about the Ivy King Cup. It's something that the Windy City Rollers put on every year. Currently, the Fury still have the championship. Sure, it's been 3 years since we had COVID, but they took very good care of it for 3 years. So it looks like we're about to get started. As we see, we don't have an actual roster right now for the officials, but we see Malice as well as Roll Call on our skating official line there. And as they skate on by, we'll be happy to shout them out as well. Maybe getting some stretches there. I thought it was 5 seconds for a minute, and I got really excited. A little bit of shiny moment. This is exciting. So we all haven't worked together as announcers, commentators on this game. How are you feeling as far as, the progression of roller derby this year?
You know, there's a lot going on, I think, all over, especially the United States. I know there's a lot going on in Europe as well. I haven't heard too much news out of Australia yet. We know that New Zealand Roller Derby and Australia Roller Derby is definitely active, and we've streamed, you know, a lot of those games, and New Zealand even has their own Twitch channel, but they think there's definitely a lot happening, and everyone's very excited to see what the WFTDA, the new competitive pathway is going to bring, the new algorithms.
Oh. Fun. I love that perspective. So yeah. So as we get started here today, it looks like we're gonna start off GM number one. Vamp, who's on that line there for double crossers?
Yeah, so it looks like Hell's Bells put out Chelsea Dragger in red and Double Crossers put out Crisscross in black. So right now we are seeing that the Double Crossers Jammer has come around for a scoring pass, but was pushed out by the Hell's Bells. So really at this point we're waiting to see them get out, and they find the light on the outside line. Crisscross goes through for that initial scoring pass, gets 4 points on the board for the Double Crossers. Meanwhile, Chelsea Dragger is being worked upon by that contingent of blockers at the front of the pack, so they're still trying to work getting out of the pack here for their initial pass. Crisscross does successfully make another scoring pass and puts up 8 points so far, so only a few minutes in the jam already, and the Double Crossers are, you know, giving the Hell's Bells their own kind of personal hell at this point. And it does look like Chelsea Dragger does pass the cover over to Rachel Rage, and they manage to get out and are trying to make for some points. Looks like they hit into the pack with some speed. Let's see if they manage to get a point there, because it does look like the jammer for Double Crossers called it off here. Yeah, they managed to get 1 point. So Double Crossers at 12 points, and Hell's Bells with 1 point so far.
That was a fantastic way to start our momentum here. Jam number one. Hi from Sacramento Roller Derby. Hello to you. Thank you so much for hanging out with us.
It's the entire Sacramento Roller Derby League.
All of them.
One account. All right. Illinois now jamming for the Double Crossers here in Jam 2. Very fast lead jammer for Killinois. Is it Killinois or Killinois? Y'all have to correct me, you folks from Illinois. Going around the scoring pass right there. Oi, silent. Okay. Oi, silent. Gotcha. Going around and hitting in turn two, getting those quick 4 points. I think I've seen Killinois skate before, and she's pretty good. She's pretty good at roller derby. So that's definitely a thing. We did see that was a power jam, so Rachel Rage is coming back from the box. Did not see that penalty, but back looking like maybe an initial pass as Killinois continues to score another 4 points for the Double Crossers. A little jammer action there. Rachel Rage knocks out Killinois. Maybe determined to play defense instead of jam, but that doesn't last too long. Killinois is down back in the pack. Rachel Rage also taking that opportunity to finally make that initial pass. Killinois is going to call this jam off. It's not going to be any points for Hell's Bells on this one, and definitely at least 8 points there for the Double Crossers.
Lady Pterodactyl in the chat room shouting out for the Double Crossers. And lots of love again going on in the chat. Please join us if you'd like to commentate along with us and maybe even ask us questions as the game progresses. Killinois, you might have seen her last weekend skating at the showdown in Thibodaux, Louisiana. So we're going to go ahead and go back to jam number three. Vamp, what's happening trackside?
All right. So for the Double Crossers, they put out Beautiful Cinnamon Roll, Too Good for This World, Too Pure. And not quite sure who is out on the track for Hell's Bells, but they do get lead for Hell's Bells. So right now we're looking at the Hell's Bells jammer coming back around for a scoring pass, making a try for that inside line. But the blockers from Double Crossers are, tracking the jammer, doing their job, making sure that tripod stays strong. It does look like Double Crossers jammer gets out. So they have successfully come out of the pack. Meanwhile, the Hell's Bells jammer has made 4 points on the board. So at that point, they call it, make sure that they have no points on the board, Double Crossers, and successful jam for the Hell's Bells. So 20 points to Double Crossers, 5 points to the Hell's Bells.
Just want to point out that we do ask for pronunciations usually when we get these rosters. Sometimes we get them, sometimes we don't. We always ask for pronouns, and we always ask for officials. So if there's any names missing, it's just because they weren't provided to us. And pronunciations, you know, we always do our best, but if we're not given any kind of pronunciation guide, you know, it is just have to be our best guess. And we appreciate the corrections in the chat, and we appreciate your understanding. So go ahead, going into Jam 4, Peekaboos, jamming up against Ficus, which I think is an excellent derby name, a very unassuming derby name, maybe makes people underestimate you a bit. So Ficus is going to get out and get lead jammer for the Hell's Bells.
It was power jam, too. Peekaboos did end up going to the box. Not quite sure what the penalty was for, but definitely a nice little run for the Hell's Bells at this point.
Very nice, very nice. So Ficus again, now around here on a scoring pass, going into turn 2. Pushing the pack, everybody's slowed, not quite stopped, but we are going to see a direction on one of the Double Crossers blockers. She picks those hands up, goes right to the box. We do see Peekaboos back on the track, hoping to get that initial pass going. Out of the pack, just barely staying in bounds there, taking a last-second hit from Hell's Bells pivot. Ficus is going to go ahead and call this one off, probably picking up a few points, and 0 for the Double Crossers. Yep. 4 points. Nice. A full pass for Hell's Bells. 22, 9, 23, 45 left in this half. Plenty of time. Excuse me. Not a great lead for Double Crossers. And, yeah.
A plethora of points on the board. Hey, you know what? Come back plethora. Next Saturday, March. Plethora. Come back next plethora. Saturday, March 11th.
Let's say that word as wrong as we can. Challenge accepted.
Plethora.
Plethora. Go ahead.
Free derby name if anybody wants it. Plethora. You got it.
Oh my god.
You're welcome.
Oh lord.
Jam 7 underway. What's going on there, Vamp?
Yeah, so we have Criss Cross for lead for the Double Crossers with Chelsea Dragger right on her tail. It looks like they're doing a bit of a speed run here. Criss Cross is vying for that inside line, trying to get to the pack as quickly as possible, but calls it because they do see Chelsea Dragger right behind them with a couple of their blockers from the Double Crossers falling a bit behind, so trying to keep them from scoring those 2 points. They call it just in time, so that's a 0-0 jam for both Double Crossers and Hell's Bells, keeping them at 20-9 with Double Crossers in the lead.
Giving a shout out to people in the chat. Tear them up. Hey, how are you doing? Lady Pterodactyl, glad you're here. And go Black Eyed Bean, go Hell's Bells from 184-467.
All right, here we go. Killanoi again on the track for the Double Crossers. Hell's Bells jammer hanging out at the top of the pack. We are going to see a multiplayer on somebody, but that gives Killanoi a chance to pick up, looks like, lead jammer for Killanoi. Yep, there we go.
And Hell's Bells jammer falling close behind.
Yeah, probably about 30-ish feet, closing quickly. Killanoi going for points. Going for points.
Those get past at least one blocker hip.
Super fancy. Putting on a showcase, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Fancy in Chicago. Hey, you know, if you like what you're seeing, come back next Saturday, March 11th, for another 4-game broadcast featuring 2 games from Rat City in Seattle, followed by 2 more games from South Sea in Melbourne, Australia. Rat City is hosting a Grunge City Roller Derby along with their home teams in their third event of the season. And South Sea hosts Victorian Roller Derby League in a game recording back in October, but debuting here on Saturday night, USA time. So, Sunday midday,
super.
If you're in Australia, super Ooh. Duper good time. So make sure you join us next Saturday as well.
That was such a fast lead out the beginning from Ficus for Hell's Bells that we just did not even see it. So yeah, lead jammer Ficus. God, I love that name. It's so great. It's so great. We are seeing
it
another
just rolls off the tongue.
Double Crossers blocker heading to the box, jamming up against Beautiful Cinnamon Roll. Too good for this world, too pure. But Ficus does have lead here and is going for points. Cinnamon Roll has the star off, it looks like. And we are going to see Ficus continue to try and get through here. Tough defense, this Double Crossers team. Going into turn 3, keeping an eye on those refs who are keeping an eye on those packs. I'm waiting. We are seeing kind of a lot of penalties happening in this jam. Pack is getting split up, stretched out. Finally, a big recycle.
Yeah, it does look like Cinnamon the pivot here, for right Hell's Bells is in the box as well.
So yeah, it looks like two Hell's Bells are sitting in the box now. Full track again for the double crossers, which is not good news for Ficus, who's trying to get a little help, but it's not quite happening yet. Here we go on the outside line. You see a blocker trying to play some offense here. Ficus hoping for daylight. As Cinnamon Roll comes around, Ficus finally decides to call that one off. We're going to see a few points on the board, I believe.
Wow, yeah. Ficus has really been blowing.
13. Definitely blowing. I have a little Ficus plant at home, and if I do anything, like even if I water this plant, all the leaves fall off. But they do eventually grow back.
Yeah, mine has like little teeny tiny leaves, and they're kind of like a little curled, but you know, it's trying its best.
It's doing its best. Maybe We're all just doing our best.
Leave it alone. You should just leave it alone.
Oh, yeah.
I'll let you get back to the like... reaction and jam eight.
Chelsea, yeah, peekaboo's making like a tree.
Exactly. Peekaboo's getting lead for the double crossers. Meanwhile, Chelsea Dragger is being kept at the front of the pack by the tripod from the double crossers. Double crossers staying low, making sure that their jammer on them does not get out, but it looks like Hell's Bells did catch wind of that, are trying to give some offense, and you see them try this sweep on the inside, but it looks like Chelsea Dragger does find some daylight on the outside line, and it's coming around. Peekaboo's is... Where is Peekaboo's? That is the question. They go to the box?
You gotta catch them all. You gotta catch them all. Sometimes.
Yeah, Peekaboo's is in the box. They lost the lead. So it does give Hell's Bells a chance to, get some points on here. Chelsea Dragger did get 4 points and is coming around for a second pass. The blockers are trying for an inside sweep to the out to assist Chelsea Dragger to come through the inside, but does take a bit of a spill. Peekaboo's comes in with speed and knocks a couple of Hell's Bells blockers down, so they do come out with some power and some panache, but it looks like the Hell's Bells are, trying to make sure that they keep that defense tight, keep that, it looks like a bit of a scrum here at the first turn here. Oh, Peekaboo is down for the count. Knocked to the inside line with a blocker from Hell's Bells. Chelsea Dragger comes around for the third scoring pass. Also gets knocked down by a blocker here to the inside line. So it looks like a bit of a bit of trouble trying to stay on their skates here, but that's no problem. The jam ends with 10 points on the board for Hell's Bells, 4 points for Double Crossers. So it's just a 2-point game now. 25 to the Double Crossers, 23 for the Hell's Bells. So they are trying to keep this close, keep it tight. Definitely a good game so far, despite the penalties.
Some of the officials, some of the officials you might be seeing here are Matricia Alcoholic, as well as Machete Page from Chicago. Jam 9 underway.
All right. Here we go. Chris Cross. Looks like Tara Fatal. I'm not sure. Tina Fatal. I can't read that. I'm trying my best. Lead jammer not assessed. Tina Fatal. Looks like Tina Fatal is not in the box. That's somebody just with a red helmet. Crisscross jamming in black. Almost out on the outside. Blocker falls down. I see something flew out of the camera range there. But anyway, Crisscross is your lead jammer for the double crossers. Tina Fatal not in the box. Also out behind her now on a scoring pass. So probably going to be a quick one. We're going to see Crisscross looking for points and going to call it right there. 25 to 23.
Any points scored there? That's
maybe. Yeah. Yep, some points. Yeah, so 5-point game. Here we go. Hell's Bells caught up quick. It's the Hell's Bells pivot that's sitting in the box right now, standing. So.
Right. So, yeah, they're down one in the Hell's Bells blocking lineup, but that's no problem. They're adjusting, trying to figure out where they're best positioned to give some nice offense. It looks like they are positioned Right next to that Killanoid GM. Yeah, Killanoid is out on the track for Double Crossers, while Ficus is out there for Hell's Bells. They are at the back of the pack. Looks like the Double Crossers have a nice setup there, a nice tripod, but the Hell's Bells blockers do go in for that nice quick offense. Ficus does push them to the front of the pack, though, and it looks like the Killanoid is out for that scoring pass. So 4 points on the board for Double Crossers. The cover for Hell's Bells has been passed, but not in time. It looks like the jam is called by the Double Crossers jammer. So we are now at 8 points for the Double Crossers, 0 to Hell's Bells, 36 points on the board for Double Crossers, 23 for Hell's Bells.
The coaches for the Double Crossers, Grizz Arrington and Jumping Spider.
I love Jumping Spider. Mm-hmm. He's so fun to call games with. He's so fun. All right, here we go. Beautiful Cinnamon Roll, too good for this world, too pure, up against Chelsea Dragger, who maybe is not too pure for this world. Chelsea Dragger, that's a good one. Jamming for Double Crosses, Hell's Bells, respectively. Chelsea, they're right in the back, but not for long. Beautiful Cinnamon Roll here, getting recycled back quickly by the Hell's Bells pivot number 6. Looking for that inside line, maybe getting out, maybe not. Both packs are doing a really great defensive job here. Everyone's just sort of trading places, whether they're in the front of the pack or the back of the pack. You love to see it. But that is going to be a lead jammer for Beautiful Cinnamon Roll, too good for this world, too pure. A nice little slide out in the inside for Chelsea Dragger, who recycles back in behind the Double Crossers pack as Cinnamon Roll comes in for a scoring pass.
And we're looking at that blocker. The pivot for Double Crossers does take a bit of a spill, but did a brave attempt in keeping that Hell's Bells jammer back. But Chelsea Dragger did get the best out of that and comes out, but not in time. How many points shaked out there, Chai?
One. 1 point.
And that does speak to defensive lineup.
We definitely know that Roll Call and Malice are OPRing, so, you know, thank you. Shout out to the referees.
The coach then for the Hell's Bells is DeFleurd. And I can't see all the way to their bench, but as soon as they come closer to the camera, I'm sure I can recognize them, hopefully. While we're taking the timeout, courtesy of Hell's Bells, I just want to let you know some more upcoming dates, so save the dates. March 16th to the 19th is BOTUS, Battle of the All-Stars. And then we have California Derby Galaxy season opener on March 18th. The 31st of March through April 2nd, you'll be watching Clover Cup. And awesomely, we will see on April 15th through the 16th, BIPOC Bowl. Make sure you make those notes so that you can save those dates. I can't wait for the
BIPOC Bowl.
That's going to be my favorite. And Clover Cup, oh my gosh. Perfect. Yeah,
Clover Cup is going to be I think it's going to be some good matchups. We're going to see a lot of folks that we saw skating at the All-Stars tournament last weekend, skating at Clover Cup. So definitely going to be a good one. Definitely watch.
I will be excited because I will be there.
Very nice. That's right.
Yep.
All right.
So hopefully you guys will be announcing.
We'll see what happens. Lining up jam 11, maybe?
Right. Yeah, looks like they're getting ready. All the way up to pivot line.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, seeing a little teammates high fives. Here we go. Jam 12, Crisscross versus Tina Fatal. Tina Fatal. Looking on the outside. I think, yep, that was her pivoting earlier that I saw. So taking turns jamming and pivoting here. We do see Crisscross in the back, but Tina Fatal picks up lead jammer. Crisscross working just past this pivot line here. Mm-hmm. Trying to get out, getting a little bit of offensive help, but they've got to really catch Tina Fatal here and keep her from moving, but it looks like they're not going to be able to. Knocking her out of bounds to the inside. Nice big recycle. Oh, crisscross goes to the box on a cut call. So power jam Hell's Bells. Tina Fatal, lead jammer, 4 points on the board for Hell's Bells. Well, this is exactly the kind of jam that they needed to catch up to the double crossers here. Maybe we'll see a lead change. We'll just see how long it goes, or if they decide they want to ice crisscross in the box here.
Pack starts moving as Tina.
I know. Pack starts moving as Tina comes up to the pack. So it's an interesting choice by them. But it does create a little space for her to get out and pick up 4 more points. A double crossers blocker heads to the box as a crisscross comes back. Looks like maybe star in hand. So maybe looking for the star pass, looking for that pivot. We are going to see looks like a multiplayer call on a blocker. Yep, on a Hell's Bells blocker. Tina Fatal goes ahead, picks up 4 more points. Crisscross gets out of the pack, but we're going to end that jam. Just make it a 2-point game, you know, for fun, as a treat. 12 points for Hell's Bells on this one.
Yeah, great
the
job.
The WFTDA. Oh, go ahead.
Oh, go ahead. No, you go ahead.
No, you.
No, you.
No, I'm just kidding. So the WTD, I just want to let everybody know that they're pleased to announce that they will begin the game sanctioning this year. So they're implementing new competitive system based on geographic regions, and it focuses on recovery and sustainability. So they have adjusted the rankings algorithm to promote more gameplay by enabling teams to compete against a wider variety of opponents.
Yeah, so it does look like Killanoia out there got sent to the box. They did drag a Hell's Bells blocker down to the ground, so did get called on that. Ficus is out for lead for Hell's Bells, so definitely a good last two jams so far for the Hell's Bells. They do a bit of a run to not allow the double crossers blockers to get any rest or reform, so they get out for a quick 4-point pass here. Now the double crossers are set up. They've got their bearings. They have one at the front, one blocker at the front trying to track them. Does look like Killanoia's back on the track, finds that inside line, but not fast enough. It looks like the jammer for Hell's Bells, Ficus, calls that. So now we are at 5 points on the board for Hell's Bells with 0 for the double crossers. There is a lead change, so 40 points to Hell's Bells and 37 double crossers.
Lead change.
Game on.
Yes.
Yeah. Good stuff.
10 minutes left in the first half, and yeah, lead change. Yeah, let's do it.
We love.
Hey,
to
welcome
see
to
it.
The chat. Looks like Braze is Satan watching from Mexico City. Awesome. We love it when we have folks from other places watching roller derby. It helps that we're pretty much close to the same time zone, if not the same time zone. So yeah, that's nice too.
And Braze Satan was in the Chicagoland area for some time, so thanks for tuning back in and enjoying some maybe your old league meets there. That's awesome.
That is an awesome, awesome derby name. What?
I love when people do a lot of wordplay in their names. It warms my heart as an English major.
Aww. Keep them guessing.
Yeah, it's so good.
All right, here we go.
All right, Malort break is over. Get back to roller derby.
Malort.
Play. Jam 14.
Oh my god! If you've never had Malort, it's probably best that you don't start.
True fact.
You have been warned.
All right, here we go.
We have on the track.
The double crossers and the Hell's Bells are on the track right now.
That's fair. That's fair.
All right, here we go for real this time. We don't know who's jamming yet because they haven't run past the camera. We are seeing somebody rejoin from the box here. Nice and slow re-entry. You love to see it.
Absolutely.
Here we go.
Yeah, 27, so Chelsea Dragger is out there for the Hell's Bells. And trying to
lead.
Get past that.
Yeah, lead is going to the double crossers.
Let's see, who is that? Give me their number. Number 16.
16.
Ah, where did it go? So crisscross, a familiar matchup. Crisscross and Chelsea Dragger. Crisscross calling that off pretty quick. after getting their 4 points on the board and another lead change again, 41 to 40 double crossers in the lead.
So that's the kind of game it's going to be, is it?
Swapping out points, swapping out lead.
That's how it's going to be. You know what? A whole team really mostly choosing leopard print bottoms. I'm into this. I'm fun. That's fun. Look at all these blockers.
Little crab walk.
All right, black-eyed bean jamming up against Killinois. Killinois lead jammer for the double crossers.
Yeah, they broke through that tripod like so quick.
Super great offense, but they got to reform. They got to catch Killinois, and she's just gone. Yeah, they weren't ready for it, so there she goes. Points and calling it.
Killinois had no mercy for it. The Hellsbells nor their own blockers on the double crossers just burst through both the packs with speed, with grace, and with 4 points on the board.
That's so fancy. It sounded like a poem. Speed and grace.
And she'll block you in the face.
She'll block you in the face.
You can't.
No, she's
that.
That's not allowed.
Minor
incidental contact with the head is a penalty, just so everybody knows. Beautiful cinnamon roll, too good for this world, too pure, up against Ficus.
Yeah. So that was number 21. Pick
coming back from the box, slowing down, trying to play some offense. Is it working? It's starting to work, and Ficus is out of the pack as this beautiful cinnamon roll, too good for this world, too pure, comes back. Oh, maybe he's not lead.
No, Ficus is lead, yeah.
Ficus
sure.
is lead. Okay. Cinnamon Roll's taken off the star.
They're trying to find, I think that's Tricky Pixie for double crossers in the pivot helmet, but they are working that top tripod.
You see those feet?
Trying to keep back Ficus. Oof. Yeah, Tricky Pixie
see
is
those,
quite
did you see
the
those
pivot.
Feet?
Yeah.
So Cinnamon Roll took the star, was trying to pass it, saw an out, and got out of there.
Great job by Tricky Pixie there with that decisive hit, knocking Ficus out and, you know, forcing them to call that off as, Cinnamon Roll was coming back around.
Oh, a roll coming back around? Didn't see that coming. Baked goods are very, very tricky.
Delicious.
In the chat, did you see that Malort is bad grapefruit mixed with rubbing alcohol?
Ew.
So yeah, you can drink it as well as help solve wounds, you know? It's a safety
or,
tool.
You know, use it to clean your derby gear. Ew.
Hey.
Crisscross versus Rachel Rage. Rachel Rage fighting that last blocker, 1975 there, to get lead jammer.
Yep, you're correct.
No star pass. Yeah, I am correct. Yeah, Crisscross also now out of that pack. Rachel Rage hitting the pack pretty hard. Walker falls down, taking a little slow to get up there.
Yeah, they're doing a great job.
Everyone's yelling something. not a bad idea to clean derby gear. Yeah, honestly. And if you haven't cleaned your gear in the recent past, maybe you should.
Yeah, if you open your trunk or your gym bag and you smell it before you open it, might be a problem.
Ew.
And if this entices you, you might just want to join roller derby. You never know. Everybody has their, you know, fun times, okay?
Yep.
No shame in our roller derby game.
There's a little shame.
We accept you.
Right.
We accept you whether
shame.
You're
please
hygienic
wash your
or
gear.
Not.
That's fair.
It is a little frowned upon if you come in.
Yeah, don't give yourself or anybody else MRSA.
That's a
smart.
Nice request. You know, speaking of wellness, WFTDI Wellness has some exciting projects in the work, including first aid training, nutrition, injury recovery, and more. Learn more at WFTDI.com.
And on the track here, we have double crossers Killinois working that outside line, finding lead status here. Meanwhile, Black Eyed Bean is at the back of the pack, trying to find some outside line as well, and they do get out. Meanwhile, Killinois coming out for a scoring pass here. Looks like Killinois is in the box, actually. Is it? Or is that a blocker? Am I seeing things?
Maybe.
Yeah, I'm seeing things. It's
always possible.
It is a blocker that went to the double to the box from the double crossers, but the jam was called by the double crossers jammer. They did get 8 points on the board before they called it, so 57 points lead for double crossers with the 47 points for the Hells Bells. So 10 points right now.
What if we called the penalty box the double crossing box?
Oof.
You know?
That actually it does sound catchy.
It's kind of fun. Peekaboo's up against Chelsea. Dragger, Chelsea. Dragger looking for that outside line with the fast feet. But, ooh, Peekaboo's is actually going to get out and get lead. Take a little bit of a spill there. But that's okay. She's up fast. Chelsea Dragger also out of that pack on a scoring pass. So, you know, Peekaboo's has got a chance to maintain that lead there. Probably going to get some points and call it off because it's you know, their lead to lose, right? They got 3 minutes left to think about it.
Right.
Yep. There we go. Points and calling it.
And it was an interesting move of that double crossers blocker in the back to try to delay that Hell's Bells jammer. Risking that point is, you know, not the kind of business you want in roller derby, but they tried it and I think they successfully, you know, kept them back long enough for double crossers to get that 1 point on the board. All right, setting up here for jam 19 with 2 minutes and a half left on the clock. Crisscross for the double crossers and Ficus for Hell's Bells. Crisscross is trying to work against that two blocker defense and is pushing them to the front with so much force, but it looks like that pivot for the Hell's Bells push them out, but does fall backwards, allowing Crisscross to come back inside pretty quick. They get lead after fighting off that last blocker. So Crisscross with lead coming around for a scoring pass. Meanwhile, Ficus is working the back of the pack. They do have the star in hand, trying to pass it to their pivot, but the pivot is trying to work there. But with that distraction, they do allow Ficus to come out of the pack. But Crisscross is too quick. Gets a couple of points probably in that exchange and calls it. So actually they get full 4 points there. So good for them. They fought for their points. Got all four. 62 points now for the double crossers and 47 still for the Hell's Bells.
We have 1 minute and 20 seconds remaining in this first half. We want to give you a shout out to the Wii FTDA. Be part of the roller derby conversations on the WFTDA online community. Sign up is easy and you'll be able to connect with other folks, skaters, officials, announcers, commentators, volunteers returning to roller derby from near and far. Find out more information at community.wftda.org.
Illinois up against Black Eyed Bean here. Very quick footwork by the Hell's Bells pivot to recycle Illinois back, but Illinois takes a little bit more space just to get a little more speed and just hops right through lead jammer. Black Eyed Bean now also out on a scoring pass, so again, I think we're going to see a fast one, unless Illinois decides, you know, there's 30 seconds left on the clock, we may as well run it and see what happens. They've got a solid lead. And, it, you know, again, clock kill would be cool. 62 to 47. Illinois is going to call that one off after picking out a few points there.
Yeah, so they
iced that. He was three,
that.
Several was four, right?
Right. They iced those two blockers from the double crossers in the box in the process.
Smart.
Yeah.
Some would like to call that even strategy, if you will.
Perhaps.
Perhaps.
But yeah, Illinois maybe should have let that, I guess it's going to be the halftime. Illinois maybe should have let that one go a little bit longer to get her blockers out of the box there. So double crossers in the lead, but going to start down two and the second half.
Yeah,
I feel a little bit double crossed right now because I thought we were going to get one more jam, but no, you're going to go to the halftime. So the score right now is double crossers at 65, your Hell's Bells at 47. We're going to take a small break and come back to you in about 12 to 13 minutes to give you the conclusion of this game. So stick around. I've been Cakes with Chai, and well, is Vamp, and we're excited to bring you some more of the Windy City quadruple game on Saturday. So stay tuned and stick around.
Woo!
All right. Hey, welcome back, everybody. Thanks. Oh, Jinx, you owe me a Coke.
You owe me a Coke.
All right.
That's how it works.
That's fair.
Okay, so,
that's
okay. Fair. Cakes, you're a local gal. Tell me about this floor, because I know everyone's burning question is about the floor. So, So this is a basketball
very
court.
Shiny. Yes, there's many lines in which you can choose to be remain in bounds. So it keeps you guessing. I think this is actually more of a strategy than anything else. Actually, I have not been to this facility, so this is new to my eyeballs. But I know that it is like a sport court style. Like, you know, it's soft, it's squishy, but it's also kind of slick. So
I don't think I like that. Yeah. I never liked sport court.
I've been on floors like that where they were like squishy yet also hard.
Yeah.
No fun.
I mean, great for your bones and whatever soft part falls on it, but also not great for you staying up. So.
Yeah.
Or as we've like seen me, a couple of times.
All the edge work that requires you to slide a tad bit.
Yeah, we saw some of the defenders from the double crossers doing a huge, like, baseball safe slide at the end of the first, you know, period there towards the end. So, yeah, it is a little bit hit and miss. But, you know, what you're witnessing here is a really good game. We were talking on the break about, you know, Hell's Bells showing up in the, like, last month against the Manic Attackers. And that was kind of interesting, almost a whole blowout situation. And now they're actually hanging with the double crossers. So that's interesting.
Yeah, this game could really go either way. Like, honestly, all it's going to take is a couple of bad, you know, jammer penalties for them. And Hell's Bells, I think, will really capitalize on that. You know, is this a league that, like, will go long if they're down big? You know, are they going to, if they get lead, they're like, we need to get as many points as we can. Are they going to go for it?
We'll see here soon. Time will tell.
Time will tell.
What other cliches can we?
I know you want to say yes.
I can't give any strategy. I have to remain impartial as best I can here.
So oh my God! Whatever.
Doing my very best.
Yeah, we know your team is up next.
Give it time. Literally.
No. We tell us all the spicy stuff. Let's get spicy. Almost a blowout. Yeah, Ben's telling us. You said almost a blowout. I was like, all right, Cakes. That's not what we heard in the intermission chat. 140 point differential.
Yeah, you know, man. Anyway,
and intermission is done.
I'm doing Chai and Vamp. Thank you so much for coming back to see the conclusion of Double Crossers and Hell's Bells, the home team matchup here for Windy City Rollers. If you're just joining us, Hell's Bells is in red, Double Crossers in black, like our souls. And we'll get you some official information as we get some roster reads. I can only recognize so many people at, you know, so often. So we'll, like, it's kind of far away, and I don't know. People change their hair after a couple years. You don't know. So I'll do my
best. Or you don't really realize. You're like, all right, who's that person? And then you have to do this. Because all you've ever seen is, like, what's below their helmet. Like, wait, do this with your
feet. Oh, Lord. We still appreciate the vast amount of knowledge. So.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. As we mentioned before, the double crossers are down two blockers. So this gives a chance for Tina Fatal to try to take advantage of this, but Killanoi is pushing to the front of the pack. They're pretty fast and decisive jammer, so they do get lead here, but Tina Fatal is following close behind. They did get out pretty quick. As I mentioned, the double crossers were down too, but now they have their pivot back on the track, trying to work some offense, trying to give Killanoi some opportunities there to get past those hips, get those points. Killanoi working at the front of the pack does get knocked to the inside. Hasn't called it yet, so they are probably trying to get all 4 points before they call it.
Wow. Did you see that big recycle by Killanoi to the inside? Like, I know you're not supposed to, like, skate around the infield, but, like,
in that scenario,
I guess they have to allow it.
Yeah. But Tina Fatal did get out of the pack, so both parties do get 3 points out of that exchange. So Double Crossers now at 68 points, Hell's Bells at 50. So pretty evenly matched jam there. But let's see what happens in this next jam, jam two in the second half.
We also have some more officials that I can recognize. Referee Phil Doe and WB Skeets, also some of your officials this weekend.
Love officials. Can't do derby without them.
Mm-mm.
All right, here we go. Crisscross versus Black Eyed Bean. Crisscross in the back of the pack, looking for an opening, trying to push just a little bit, trying to see if she can get in the middle there. Black Eyed Bean working on that outside line, looking at the inside. We've just seen some really great defensive work by both of these teams so far this game. Everyone's just kind of trading places in the pack, and it's really on these jammers to realize when there's daylight in front of them and to move their feet and get out. So I think, you know, really, really strong defensive. I love what that says about Windy City as a whole for this year and for, you know, the coming years as we all get it kind of back together. But yeah, Crisscross taking advantage finally of the pack splitting up enough to get lead. So 68-50 so far. Crisscross in the lead here. See, you know, a blocker in the box for Hell's Bells, but Black Eyed Bean is now also out on a scoring pass. Crisscross knocked out to the inside. We'll see. Knocked out to the outside. Other team preventing the recycle, but she's going to call that one off. We are not going to see, you know, just maybe but a couple of points here. 12-point game so far.
Yeah, I believe that was
Bells.
Yeah, I believe that was number 47, Ramen Noodles, who made that decisive hit and forced that call off there. So good on them for, you know, being the best blocker they can be out there.
Yeah, Ramen Noodles, great work there. Huge improvement. She's doing a great job this entire game.
All right, in this next Jam 3, we have Double Crossers, Beautiful Cinnamon Roll, Too Good for This World, Too Pure, and Hell's Bells, Chelsea Dragger. The Black Jammer is being held to the back of the pack. A very strong pinch there, dragging them to the outside, but, you know, Cinnamon Roll is not going to be pushed around and, you know, stays inbounds, working that inside line and slips through the inside line, using the momentum from that blocker to get out and get lead. Chelsea Dragger is at the back of the pack, trying to get some offensive help from their team, but the blockers for the Double Crossers are down and low in that tripod, making Chelsea Dragger work for it. Cinnamon Roll is pushed the inside and dragged to the back, recycled all the way back as far as they can go without, you know, destroying the pack there. The pivot for the Double Crossers is making sure to maintain that pack definition there. So good job. Cinnamon Roll is trying to work the inside line, is pushed back out. So strong defensive and offensive work from the Hell's Bells here. All right, Chelsea Dragger now switched places with Cinnamon Roll and now is at the back of the pack. Meanwhile, Cinnamon Roll is working the front. Does get some offense from their pivot, number 140. Cinnamon Roll just has one more blocker to play off of. Takes the outside, gets out for that scoring pass and a well-deserved 4 points. Does look like the jammer for the Hell's Bells at this time has gotten out as well, and now they're playing a little bit of a racing game here. Cinnamon Roll trying to vie for the last few points, but, you know, that's the end of that jam, you know. Double Crossers, 4 points on the board. Hell's Bells held scoreless. 76 Double Crossers, 50 Hell's Bells.
I just want to say something that I love this Cinnamon Roll, Too Good for This World, Too Pure. Like, what a name, number one. And I love that we're taking every opportunity to try and say the entire thing. And I actually never want to hear again that my name is too long for people to say. It's Chykilski, and
yeah,
it's one word.
That is fair.
Killinoy versus Ficus. Killinoy lead jammer for the Double Crossers. Ficus right there in the back, trying to push the effects apart, getting really, you know, a lot of success, getting a little offense. They do not reform in time to even slow Killinoy down. Picks up 4 points. And another blocker heads to the box here. Ficus now out on a scoring pass as well. Killinoy has extended this lead to 30 points. But Ficus is out on the scoring pass. Killinoy is not even going to let her get close to the pack. She's going to call that one off. So that is going to be 4 points at least on the board there for Double Crossers, 82-50.
Some more of the officials that I'm seeing on the track there. Lisa Fury, Theo Snackjaw Jones, Tyron Lanniscore are also skate side, if you will. And I also believe Aaron Gobral, but can't confirm nor deny. We also have Illinois available as well.
So in that last jam, they did pick up another 4 points. So it's 84-50 now for double crossers. Now in Jam 5, we do have the double crossers crisscross out, along with Black Bean for the Hell's Bells. Crisscross does get out for lead pretty quick, and Black Eyed Bean pushing that tripod forward. It looks like they managed to get one of the double crosser blockers to go to the box. They did pick up a penalty there, but that is no problem because they still have three people out there doing their best. It does look like Crisscross is trying to work a few more hips in there before they call the jam. So they do, no, they do get how many points? I'm trying to see if they got any points out of that exchange. Yep, they got 3 points. 3 points for double crossers. So 87-50, double crossers in the lead. A timeout did get called by the Hell's Bells, so we do have a team timeout at the end of this jam now.
37 points separating these two teams. It's anybody's game at this point, clearly, right? I'm just kidding. If anybody's playing commentator bingo, I wanted to throw that one in there for you. It's kind of a large score gap here in Hell's Bells, although really heavy hitting on the defensive line, starting to slow their momentum here. Double crossers playing that long game and really doing a lot of finesse in this last
yeah,
half.
I think Hell's Bells defense is still just as good as ever. I think their jammers are just having a very hard time with double crossers defense. And again, they're going to need to get some help. You know, Hell's Bells is going to need to maybe not rely on four blockers to stop a jammer. I mean, it doesn't look like they are right now, but that fourth blocker is not really doing a whole lot as an offensive player either. So, you know, the packs are staying close together. It's really not getting stretched out. But I think that's what we want to see from Hell's Bells is just an adjustment to make sure that, you know, whoever's hanging out is helping the jammer in some way.
Agreed.
Here we go. End of that. Going into Jam 6, Peekaboos versus Tina Fatal. Tina Fatal taking a spill at the top of the pack here. Just a monster blocker and a jammer. Yeah, I think that is going to be a cut. She did not pass everybody yet. One person did run back, so the person she passed might have gone out of bounds that she saw, but not everybody. So, again, power jam for Peekaboo is the opposite of what we said we would have liked to see. So, Peekaboo's now jamming, not out on the initial yet. Recycling back behind, going almost back to that jam line. Blockers playing a little chicken over here on the line.
Yeah, Nasty Al, I believe, 1975, was out there giving their jammer a bit of a, you know, direction
yeah,
there
you
to
see
get back in the pack.
See the goat there, and then the pivot's like, no, I'm not a goat. Here we go, Tina Fatal back from the box. We are going to see a multiplayer call on, yep, one of those Hell's Bells blockers. Oh, another power jam for double crossers. See Jump and Spider there making the universal power jam motion. Star off of Peekaboos, looking for the pass. Maybe not going to get it. So no lead now is possible. This is going to be the two-minute jam. We've only got 30 seconds left. Big recycle on a pivot, you know, in a bid to kind of make the pack stay in the back. It only works if everybody's paying attention, am I right? Peekaboos out. It only works if everybody's looking. Peekaboos now out on a scoring pass. 12 seconds left. Massive defensive jam here for both teams. Tina Fatal out of the box. Again, another multiplayer call on a double crossers blocker this time as this jam ends. Lots of multiplayers this game, so maybe there's going to be a drill in Wendy's future where they're like, all right, drop the arms if somebody touches them.
Oh, I know that's definitely going to show up on the
right?
This, yeah, the
training
drills
schedule for sure.
Oh, uh-huh. Yeah. I know everybody's taking it out.
Oh, my gosh. I'm glad we don't have to look at that, you know, the long game as far as seeing everything that they're going to put in for the next training.
Oof. Yeah, Killanoise there comes in with speed and breaks through that Hell's Bells blocker formation pretty quick, getting lead. Ficus also dragging the pack to the front and, you know, working against one more blocker, but does get knocked down, and they're going to get recycled back a little bit. Still trying to work against that tripod up front. Meanwhile, Killinoy coming around again, works that inside line and is out for that first scoring pass, getting 4 points on the board for double crossers. We do see that Ficus...
That's the second scoring pass.
Second? Well...
Are you watching the right screen?
Potentially. That's Killinoy calling it off for that. You know what, Killinoy... went around so quick, I didn't even catch it because I was also trying to figure out.
You didn't even see that apex jump.
They went three full scoring passes, and I dropped the ball there. Killinoy was too quick for my eyes.
You're so fast, you only saw one of them.
Lord have mercy.
Either you see the unicorn go through the center of the track? Did either of you see that, or was that just me?
No unicorn. I'm watching roller skaters and referees only.
Correct.
All right. You almost fell into my crossers... trap. Congratulations.
But the double crosser did hit that century mark. We're at 101 and Hell's Bells at 50. So right now we are at jam 8 now. Crisscross on the track. And Chelsea Dragger for the Hell's Bells. All right. So right now we see Crisscross taking the inside line. Did they get lead? Yes, they were awarded lead. So Crisscross with lead for the double crossers. Meanwhile, Chelsea Dragger does get out of the pack and is coming around for their first scoring pass. The blockers for the Hell's Bells do knock Crisscross out. And Crisscross is going to the box now, losing lead for, a cut call.
Cut track, yeah.
Yep, giving Chelsea Dragger the chance to make some points here on a power jam. So they are out for their scoring pass. Just waiting for those points to be reflected on the board. So now we're at 54 for Hell's Bells. Chelsea Dragger is coming in again for a second scoring pass and just breaks through that spread out double crossers pack for 4 more points. Does look like the double crossers, though, have, you know, picked themselves up and are formed at the front of the pack. But we do see Hell's Bells jammer out again for another scoring pass. Crisscross did come out of the box pretty quick. 4 points on the board again here. All right, so at this point, really, both jammers just working to get to basically one-up each other at this point. Chelsea Dragger and Crisscross are out. Who's going to the box? Looks like a Hell's Bells. Is that the pivot in the box now? It's a little hard to see. Yeah, I think that might be the pivot. So 12 points each for both the Double Crossers and Hell's Bells. Double Crossers in the lead with 113 on the board and 62 for the Hell's Bells.
We have a shout out here in our chat room. Donuts. We have a shout out here in the chat. Still rooting for the Hell's Bells. It's going to be a great comeback, I hope. Thank you, Magic Jack, for that positivity, the power of positivity. Hopefully that intention comes through in jam number 9.
All right, here we go with Beautiful Cinnamon Roll, Too Good for This World, Too Pure, and Betty Rage. Not to be confused with Rachel Rage, who also jams for Hell's Bells. So here we go. Cinnamon Roll recycled back behind this jam line here as Beautiful Cinnamon Roll continues to try and push past the pivot line. Neither team is having it, so, you know, here we go. Great defensive game happening right here. Refs are all paying really close attention. We are seeing some help from the pivot, and I think that is going to be lead jammer for Beautiful Cinnamon Roll, Too Good for This World, Too Pure. Betty Rage still working on getting out this initial pass. We are seeing, star pass completed. We're seeing the refs make the hand signals for that star pass. Got a couple of blockers to beat. Oof, falling down to the outside, getting recycled back as Cinnamon Roll makes their way around for this scoring pass. Here we go. Yep, maybe almost out. One blocker to beat who falls down. Sometimes when you run out, you make mistakes there. 4 points on the horse for double crossers. Court. I know, right? No, the sport court, come on, I love sport court. This doesn't look like real sport court. I'll die on this hill. I love Sport Court. Betty Ridge still getting, yeah, star pass completed. So that's a whole new jammer right there. They figure may as well put on that star, even though they haven't done the initial yet, as Mimenroll picks up four more points for the double crossers. Just under 14 and a half minutes left in this game, 18 seconds left in this jam. Mimenroll, you know, being told to run it probably, since, you know, the other one's still in their initial. That's rough when you're a newer jammer. But here we go, 7 seconds left. Going to try and pick up the rest of those 4 points before this jam ends. And that's going to be the end of it. It looks like it's going to be a zero jam for Hell's Bells. Big jam for double crossers, extending that lead. Gosh, 60 points now. 10-0 jam, 123-62, double crossers.
Now, not that I went on a fact-finding mission, but they are skating on McCook Center, Athletic and Exposition Center. This is a sport court, not a skate court, and it does have a little bit more give for the skater. So I will also die on that hill with you, Chai. I actually love sport court. Skate court, I can't stand, but sport court, wonderful.
Yes,
enough about the court.
Thank you.
Jam 10.
Nope. I will always prefer polished concrete, but that's just me. Anyways, double crossers, Killinois is out of the pack pretty quick, as they have a pretty amazing talent of, you know, picking up speed and finding the seams pretty quick. Black-Eyed Bean at the back. Oh, no, Black-Eyed Bean out behind Killinois, trying to win that little race there to get some points here, but Killinois, being as fast as they are, called it before Black-Eyed Bean even has a chance to touch the pack. So 4 points for the double crossers, 0 for the Hell's Bells, 127-62. But yeah, Killinois is just an excellent jammer with a lot of speed, so very good jam. But on the point of sport court, I can't do it. Maybe it's because I've just skated on polished concrete for all this time. I'm not used to it.
somebody, one of my friends was watching, and they literally are just like, they texted me, "You and your freaking sport court, their sport court." I'm like, yeah, sport court. Deal with it. Crisscross lead jammer for the double crossers up against Ficus for the Hell's Bells. Hell, you know, Ficus, again, this is a great opportunity to give some help to Ficus here, but not doing it. They're you know, at least they're focusing on catching Crisscross here, who is going to get a little assistance, you know, from a friend to break that up. That's 140 for the double crossers. Crisscross skating backwards away from them, and hey, that works too. 4 points on the board for the double crossers as they go into turn two here, nice and slow. Ficus got one blocker to beat. You know, they're trying to prevent the recycle, but here we go.
Yeah, that Crisscross was
right back in the pack.
Front.
Getting pushed out to the inside. Yeah, it looks like maybe it's hard to do the slides for plows and hockey stops on this particular floor, so they're just trying to skate around folks as they can. So Crisscross again back in this pack. Ficus out. Nope, star pass completed. If that's number six, yeah, if that's number six, that's probably Tina Fatal there taking the star, so we'll have to see if that was her. And Crisscross looking for the call-up from the bench, finally gets it, calls it off. Great listener. Just a few more points on the board for the double crossers there.
Roller derby insurance is one of the most important things to have on your person when you're skating a roller derby. If you're getting back on track, make sure your insurance is current. Log on to the member portal to check your coverage status, or go to WFTDI.com for more information. WFTDI insurance is valid for 1 year from date of purchase. Canadian leagues and skaters can go at WFTDICanada.ca for member benefits and information.
Excellent. And then here on Jam 12, we have Pika Bruise for the double crossers and Chelsea Dragger for the Hell's Bells. With the speed that they've got here, they're moving the pack pretty quick. Pika Bruise, with the amount of speed that they had, unfortunately did get knocked down by a blocker and are recycled to the back of the pack, allowing Chelsea Dragger to get lead here, push back that last couple of blockers from the double crossers. So Chelsea Dragger with lead for the Hell's Bells. So if they do manage to get a couple scoring passes here, we should see the tides turned a little bit here for the Hell's Bells. Peekaboos is being held very, very tightly by that tripod there at the front of the pack.
Playing a little peekaboo.
But it looks like Peekaboo has taken off the cover, trying to find their pivot. But it looks like that pivot for the double crossers is trying to help out with keeping Chelsea Dragger back. But Chelsea Dragger does get out for that scoring pass. Looks like the Hell's Bells pivot has gone to the box. All right, in that confusion, it looks like Chelsea Dragger is pushing the pack forward, has a couple more blockers to push past for another scoring pass here. It does look like Peekaboos is now trying to maintain pack definition, but did cause possibly a destruction of pack there, so they're going to the box. But they have passed, I believe, the star cover to a double crossers pivot, who has gotten out of the pack here. So they're following Chelsea Dragger now, but Chelsea Dragger does call it off now that they've gotten a couple more points on the board here. So yeah, a full 4 points there on that last run before they called it off. So Hell's Bells did get the best out of this jam. 12 points on the board to Double Crossers is 0. So 135 Double Crossers, 74 Hell's Bells.
Now, I know there's a lot of competition happening on the track, but in our chat line, we have another comment. Sundays actually going in to say that they much prefer the maple hardwood of a nice rink. And I have to say, I love what you're saying here, but I strongly disagree. Oh, my goodness. Are you bananas?
I love Swore Court.
I mean,
I've never skated on hardwood.
You know when I say that I love Swore Court? I'm like the cat with the meme where the lady's pointing at the cat and the cat's like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I can see that.
Sundays, we love that you are, coming in and telling us your opinion. We want more of those opinions. If you want to help us keep this conversation going, here's my rankings, okay? Sport court, then we have polished concrete, then I have skate court, and then I have the rink. Blech. Roller
rink. I agree
with you. No, thank you.
I agree with you. I think we're soulmates.
Did we just become best friends?
I think we're soulmates. I think we're best friends.
It just happened.
All right, here we go. GM14, double crossers, Hell's Bells. Everybody's playing roller derby. Big recycle back behind the jam line on the double crossers jammer there. I don't see who that is yet, but hey, you know what? Hell's Bells got lead. How about it? Let's go, Hell's Bells fans in the chat. We do see that other jammer get out behind them, but we're not paying attention to that. We're looking for points for Hell's Bells right now. People coming back from the box. Looks like maybe they're going for points, even though it looks like they got lapped now by the double crossers jammer. Everybody slowing down in turn three. Just going to go ahead and call that one off. We might see a few points. We are going to see an official review called by Jumping Spider for the double crossers. He's got 7 minutes left in this game. Both teams have some time left. Hell's Bells has one team timeout and their official review. And then, of course, Double Crossers is using their review right now, and they have two team timeouts left. Cakes.
Oh. Yes. That is me. How can I help you today?
And now a word from Cakes. Whatever she feels like saying is fine.
I want to give a shout out to Sundays because they subscribed to Prime for 3 months, so that's amazing. Thank you for being part of our awesome subscription services. We're excited that you are going to watch even more roller derby. If you follow us on Twitch, you can get notified every time we go live. And if you have Amazon Prime, you won't see any ads by using your free Amazon Prime subscription. So ask in the chat if you need help linking your account. We'd be happy to get that rolling for you. If you love those little, puns, skate puns, we're happy to bring those out to you. But yeah, Prime is a great way to get involved and have, a Twitch subscription with the WFTDA.
So
I'm receiving more angry. I'm receiving more angry text messages about Sport Court.
They can't attack
you. Look at the chat right now. Look at the chat right now. We have a poll on the best derby surface. So if you have an opinion about the best derby surface, now is your chance to take a vote, take some time, put in your vote, and let us see what surface is the best one out of all basically.
Okay.
It's the collective opinion report.
It's sport court.
I can
guarantee
if you all vote for sport court, I will do an ASMR about roller skating on sport court.
That's evil.
That'll be like a late at night derby program that you can listen to softly at 1 in the morning.
Oh my God, can you imagine calling one of these games like just whispering?
You know what, just for a fun challenge, I think Jam 14 should be a whisper jam.
I'll leave that to you, guys, if you want to take that ASMR challenge.
Yeah, new poll. Do we want a whisper jam, or will that just annoy everyone in the chat too much?
in post-editing, we're going to have this. All of our programs are right on our YouTube channel afterwards on the WFTDA YouTube channel. We'll probably get that edited out if we do a whole ASMR jam.
Oh, my God. Jam 14 is missing. No, we don't want to talk about it.
Christ.
So if this is the last time you see all three of us on a call, that's why.
It's because Wendy got upset upon reviewing all this footage.
Tear 'em Up actually says, I think a whisper jam would be hilarious. I agree. You know what? Jam 14, I challenge you both. Whisper jam.
All right, Crisscross is now jamming. Betty Rage is jamming for the hell spells. Can you even hear me? That's the question.
I can hear you.
For the Crossers. And they're coming around into turn. And they're getting hit by the Hellspell's pivot, but they're trying to go around the outside line. Betty Rage is now also out on a scoring pass. And Crisscross is getting some points. Now both jammers are out of the pack. Although I think maybe Betty Rage went to the box because we can no longer see her. And we know Crisscross is still jamming. So that's definitely a thing that's happened. Oh, there she is. There she is. Just taking a moment to get around the track nicely. So Crisscross has picked up 4 points so far. Back in the pack on the four straightaway. Betty Rage also now in the pack. It's just all together in turn three. We really can't see what's going on because all the beautiful non-skating officials are blocking my vision, but that's okay. That's a distraction that I will accept. Crisscross has now scored 4 more points, and the star pass has been completed to Black Eyed Bean for the Hell's Bells, who's been pushed out of bounds on the outside line by 1975 here. Two more blockers to beat. Crisscross continuing to score points, but not quite getting out. There we go. Out on the inside, we are seeing an illegal contact penalty assessed to 1975 Nasty Al. As Crisscross continues to jam, you know, this is a great time-eating jam for the Double Crossers, which is kind of what they need to do. But it does give Black Eyed Bean a chance to score some points for Hell Spells. Why did we pick this jam to whisper? It is so long.
I know.
Why did we do this?
The same thing. Because we love it. And it's lovely. And
we're doing it.
Is loving it.
We're doing it for the bit. And I hope that everyone has enjoyed this Whisper Jam. I am never doing it again. Thank you so much.
You know what? Just to continue, the remote studio is where you can broadcast all your games without the expense and hassle of traditional streaming. The remote studio can get your games to a global audience with as little as a smartphone. No matter your location or budget, get streaming with Remote Studio. Contact Broadcast at quadmedia.tv and check out our broadcasting for beginners resources.
All right, and we're back. Now I'm getting messages about Whisper Jams. Here we go.
That will be over. I will not be doing that.
No. But beautiful cinnamon roll, too good for this world, too pure, jamming against Ficus.
Yeah, and Ficus at the front of the
pack.
Ma'am,
you got this.
Oh, yeah. Ficus is fighting that front tripod. Meanwhile, Cinnamon Roll is being dragged to the back of the pack. Reforming, trying to figure out what their next move is. Trying for the outside, but it looks like the Hell's Bells have pushed them to the out. Ficus was also being recycled at the front of the pack. Looks like that pivot for the Double Crossers has brought Ficus all the way back to turn two there, allowing Cinnamon Roll to get lead here. Cinnamon Roll being too good for this world, too pure, coming back around for a scoring pass here. The Hell's Bells are being worked on by the pivot from the double crossers, getting some O here, but also remembering to keep pack definition there. So good on them for doing a multitask of a job there. Cinnamon Roll is working the back of the pack, still trying for the outside, goes towards the middle. One more blocker to beat against, what is that, number 81, I believe? Or, oh, getting a little closer. Does get knocked down. So it looks like Cinnamon Roll is worked on by those blockers. So definitely good job to the Hell's Bells blockers in slowing them down and forcing the call off there.
Stampeding Hoffalo's in the chat. Stampeding Hoffalo's. Sponsored by Hall's Menthol Cough Drops. And I need one after that, so yes.
You know, yeah, Hall's Cinnamon Roll. Cinnamon Roll getting completely frosted by those Hell's Bells defense. But you know what? We have a moment in our derby communications here. The Concrete wins the poll. I guess everybody likes
Tomatomas.
Courtesy of PDX Speed Bump, a.k.a. our awesome producer.
Good luck.
Thank you
good
very
luck
much
with your
that.
New calcium deposits after your blood calcifies in your body. Illinois versus Chelsea Tracker. Lead jammer for Illinois, surprising no one.
And we're in the, last two
Chelsea
minutes
drag
of the second half?
Oh my gosh, yeah, the clock's almost totally lined up. So yeah, just 2 minutes left. Quick jam. Illinois picks up 4 points, calls it off. These time kills are in their favor at this point to just get this game over with. 161-76. Double crossers definitely in the lead.
Now, WFTD insurance doesn't come with any sort of cough drop situation, but park skating is covered with WFTD insurance. So junior and bank track derby is also covered. Check out WFTDI.com to learn more about getting supplemental insurance that helps you when you get hurt on skate.
Thank you for that. And the double crossers have Crisscross on the track, who's working the front of the pack, has one more to beat, but gets knocked to the inside. Does come in pretty quick, but Ficus does get lead on that.
Ah.
Ficus with lead. So Ficus is trying to get well-earned points there for their team in the last minute or so here of this jam of the second half. Crisscross had taken off the cover, but does get out and is coming around for a scoring pass. All right. Ficus is trying to figure out their next move here, is getting held back by that excellent blocking by that double crosser blocker there. Can't quite catch their number, but they did a lot of good one-on-one tracking there against them, allowing Crisscross to get out. Ficus is recycled back a bit, knocked to the inside, got their points, gonna call it. How many points did they get there? Let's see. Looks like 4-4, so 4 to the double crossers and 4 to the Hell's Bells. So we're at 165 double crossers and 80 points to the Hell's Bells. And that should be our unofficial score now for this game, which good for the Hell's Bells to get up there in that game. I think they put up a good fight overall.
Oh, yeah.
But the double
first
crossers
half was
definitely
great.
Had a solid. Yeah, no, the double crossers did have a stronger overall switch between offense and defense, so that's where we see them edging out the Hell's Bells a little bit, but the Hell's Bells definitely did have a strong defense, enough to slow down the double crossers. So, not a complete blowout, but still a pretty decisive lead for the double crossers.
Awesome. It's almost like Hell froze over a little bit there. What do you think there, Ty?
That's it. All the thoughts are gone now.
You're welcome.
No, but great game. Hell's Bells did great in the first half. We did just see them have a little trouble switching between the defense and the offense there. Double crossers definitely had the edge, better offense overall, I think, too, on the double crosser side of things. Really improved over the last game that Hell's Bells had, and I think they're just going to do better and better as the season goes on. So, we'll be back with What game, Cakes? What game next?
The next game that you will be seeing is the Manic Attackers taking on the Fury for our next game. So we should be back here within a few moments. I know that depending on where you're at, I know that it is 8:20 p.m. on the schedule for a central time zone. So we will hopefully get that going for you in just a few moments. We'll all return for that game, I believe, and have some more commentary. Let us know in the chat when you would like the whisper jam to happen, because I feel like that's going to be a new trend for 2023. And you're going to be watching what will be another of the second part of our double header of the quadruple header of this weekend on Twitch. And it's going to just prevail as to the rankings for the IKC, which is the Ivy King Cup for the Chicagoland area. It's a Windy City Rollers tradition. So stay tuned. We will be back with another game coming to you live from the sweet home of Chicago. I've been Cakes along with Chukilski as well as Vamp, and we were very happy to call this game with you and be in the Whisper Jam situation. Let us know in the chat who you're excited to see next. We'll see you shortly.